All right, welcome back to our final video of our quarantine 30-day challenge. So to recap, 30 days ago, we started and mapped out a nutrition exercise program for myself, you know, because of lack of exercise, all the weight I gained. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to give myself 30 days to see what we're able to accomplish with an at-home plan. All right, so let's cut to the chase and see the results. Okay, so day one, we started off at 227 pounds, and day 30, we ended at 219.2. That is a loss or a scale weight loss of 7.8 pounds. Lean body mass went from 189 to 194, so that's a gain of 5. Fat mass went from 37 down to 24, so that's a fat mass loss of 13 pounds. And body fat percentage went from 16 down to 11, so that's a loss of 5% body fat. All right, like I said in my previous videos, it's been pretty easy because I've had no pressure with dropping weight. I just implemented easy nutrition changes, created a standard home workout, and just added in light cardio. As you drop more and more body fat, things will probably need to be tightened up, but doesn't need to be anything crazy. So one thing I do want to note is the importance of having a nutrition plan in combination with an exercise activity plan. If we look at a study from 2014, diet or exercise interventions versus combined behavioral weight management programs. So what that means is they compared having a diet only or exercise only plan versus a combined diet and exercise plan. So this one was pretty large. They had 8 studies within with over 1,000 participants that lasted over 18 months. The results actually showed no significant difference in weight loss from a baseline or at 3 to 6 months between the two. But at 12 months, there was a significantly higher weight loss that was shown with the combined diet plus activity exercise program. So what does that tell us? If you're starting a nutrition and exercise plan alone, it looks like you'll have higher chances of stalling out after a couple of months, which seems pretty common. If you look at it, how many people start a plan and stop seeing results shortly thereafter? So if you have a combined approach with nutrition and exercise, you're more likely to succeed in the long run. So moving on, I figured I'd give some tips if you're looking to clean things up. So let's go. So first things first, you want to limit processed foods. So you want to have an understanding of what processed foods are acceptable, which ones are not. So foods, fruits, vegetables that are washed, canned, and frozen, they might be classified as processed, but they can be good alternatives. So as long as they don't have added ingredients like salt, sugar, artificial sweeteners, flavorings, and preservatives. Now, does that mean you can't have any of your favorite either foods or snacks at all? No, what you can do is, what I tell a lot of people, is you can follow a 90-10 rule. So what that means is 90% of the time, you're gonna stick to your plan, 10% of the time, you can go outside and enjoy. So if we put this into numbers, let's say you're eating 4 meals a week times 7 days a week. That's 28 meals for the week. And that would equate to 10% being 2 to 3 meals a week that you can enjoy. Now, does that mean in those 3 meals, you can go all out, just filling yourself up with pizza, cookies, ice cream until you are absolutely full to the brim? No, you wanna still be reasonable and sensible. So if you're craving pizza, have your 2 slices and move on to your next meal. If you do blow it for that meal, you'll definitely see an impact, especially if you're doing that 2-3 times a week. So if you want to do it often, 2-3 times, depending on your meals, for example, make sure it's sensible. All right, 2, have a variety of foods. So have good protein choices, fruits, vegetables, healthy fats, grains, and carbs. This is going to ensure you have plenty of vitamins, minerals, fiber, and antioxidants in your diet. So you want to eat a variety of different foods. All right, 3, you wanna eat on schedule. So this will take the guessing and last minute work out of your day. You'll know what you're eating, how much, and when. So it's like clockwork, so you don't have to think about it. All right, 4, eat smaller meals throughout the day. So eating smaller, more frequent meals is gonna keep your metabolism moving and keep you less hungry throughout the day. All right, number five, drink plenty of water. So water deficiency can have an impact on your metabolism, your mood, your concentration, your activities, and exercise. Number six, you want to get plenty of sleep. So I think the average person needs about 6 to 8 hours. So lack of sleep can impact your insulin resistance. It can disrupt your hormones. It can also impact your physical and mental performance. And the last point is just add extra activity. So you don't have to just work out. If you can find ways for walking, jogging, swimming, playing some sports, being extra active throughout the week is gonna definitely help you in the long run. And that's it. All right, well, as far as the diet goes, I'm gonna continue to keep everything the same. I actually wanna lose a little bit more weight. I wanna hover around 8 to 10% body fat and stay there in the meantime. And we are in the beginning of June, so here in New Jersey, gyms are gonna be opening back up, hopefully in the next couple weeks. So I'm actually looking forward to getting back into the gym, getting into my regular exercise program. But with that being said, I did learn a lot here. I got used to these home workouts, so I'm gonna be doing a lot more of these, you know, throughout the week or month, just because it is convenient and it's a good change of pace. So I will be making more videos. I do love to educate people on nutrition, exercise, and healthy lifestyle habits. So if you wanna follow along, subscribe, hit that bell for future notifications. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button, show me some support, and I'll catch you in the next one.